Hi there, Jamie here today at Teachers Tech. Hope you're having a great day today. Today I want to show you how you can repair images of documents inside Microsoft Word and then turn them into a PDF after you're all done. So here's a little example. If I have an old document like this, and you can see that there's lines and everything into it, I can, in about a minute, turn it into a cleaner look and export it as a PDF inside Microsoft Word. That's what I want to show you how to do on Teachers Tech today. So I have a blank Microsoft Word document open right here. My image that I'm going to start to repair is this one right here. So if I double click on this, this is just a JPEG. If I open this up, you can see that it is a image. Now this is an old image that I'm going to modify here, but you could go use your phone, take an image of a document that maybe you didn't have a digital copy of, and then bring it over and then do any fixes to it also the way I'm showing you. So let's go ahead and insert this image now inside our Microsoft Word. To do this, we could go up to Insert and Pictures and then this device. So I would search this device. But what I'm going to do here, since I have it on my desktop, I'm just going to drag it over and plunk it right in here. Now I'm going to make a couple quick changes before I start changing, going into the picture format. I want to change the size of this. I'm just selecting this image here. I'm going to stretch it larger just to kind of fit within the margins up there. And I'm going to also change the wrapping. I'm going to click the wrapping here and I'm going to go and change it to in front of text. So just a couple changes, then I'm going to close my layout. Now, what I want to point out is when I select the image, whenever you select an image, if you look to the top and look at your tabs, I have picture format. If I'm not selected, if I don't have that selected, that tab goes away. So I select this and I have more options and I can select this and the ribbon is showing all the different things I can do. Now you can see there's corrections right here and different ways I could change this, but it's not the way I want to show you here. I'll come back and kind of show you that way towards the end. But what I like to do is do it a little bit more custom. And I'm going to go over to this right here. I'm going to click on this little square here in the ribbon, and it's going to open up Format Picture. Now, again, if you don't have the picture selected, notice one of the icons goes away. If I select it, I have the image picture here, and that's what I need to have open to format it. So when I select it, what we're going to do is make some changes to sharpness, the brightness, and the contrast. And I'm going to zoom up a little bit down below here, just so you can see it a little bit better. As I change the sharpness here, and I'm just going to up this to about 50%, and you can see right away that there's a change around the fonts to it. Now you can adjust depending on your document. You could either drag the slider here or change the number, go back and forth. I'm going to leave it at 50 for now. And then we have brightness, and I'm going to put 50 in here to see what happens. And you can see right away that it has a kind of a crisp background and everything to it. Sometimes contrast is another thing I'll change. I'll up the contrast and see if there's any differences. If I put 30 in here, I don't think it made a big change. I'll leave it as that. So I think those numbers kind of do the first step for what I want. And I'm going to just close out of my picture format and you can kind of see it here. Now, notice that they have some coils here. I'm going to go ahead and do some cropping on this. With inside picture format, when I have the picture selected, we have crop over here. And I'm just going to make it a little bit tighter. I'm going to crop the coil out because I don't want that. And I'm going to bring down just all around. This will help me get rid of any of these specs and different things that are on it that I might not want. And if I just click off it, it gets a little cleaner now. I still get some things right around here. And one way you could correct that is just to put shapes over top of it using the same color as the background. So what I mean by this, if we go up to Insert, and I'm going to go to Shapes, and we could use different shapes, but I'm going to just use this rectangle. And I'm going to draw one over top of it just like this. Now notice it goes blue. Well, I don't want that blue. That won't look very good, but I can quickly change it. If I go up to the ribbon here under shape format, drop down, turn this to white, and then do the same thing to the shape outline. Now, notice you can see it's there if I click off of it, but it hides those marks that were there. And when I turn this into a PDF, it won't matter that these things are here. There, I could go ahead and I could copy these too. So I could right click and go copy paste on it, but you could go Control C. And then if I go Control V, I have a copy. So maybe there were some specs over here that I wanted to hide. I noticed there's some here, some smaller ones. I could put a new one, or I could paste it again, Control V, and I could bring it down here and bring it and cover it up just like this. And I could go around wherever I saw. I'm going to do one more. I'll do Control V, and I'm just going to put it down in between here, and I'll make it smaller. And you understand what I'm doing to clean up any of those dots. The other thing that you might want to do, maybe these lines didn't come out quite the way I like them. I could insert some new shapes, being the line here. So if I go insert shape here, and I just grab a line here, and I could go ahead and drag it. And this way I can kind of match what the angle of this line is and just drop it. But again, the color is not right, but I just have to go up to shape outline if I want it black, and I could maybe make it a different thick. I could change the weight of it. So maybe I want it a little thicker. You could try different ones. And you could go around and place it in there. So you can still move it once. What I like to do, if I'm only moving a little bit, I might use the arrow keys on my computer and I can just nudge it down a little bit at about a time. But you can see how it just makes that line a little bit stronger. And I could go and do it for this line down below. I'm going to leave it for this example. So you want to make sure as you go through, make sure you save this too. So I'm just going to go ahead and I'm going to go and just save this. I'm going to put it on my PC here, and we'll just call this repair, just like this. So I'm going to call this repair document, and I'm going to hit save. So I have this saved and as a Word document, but I mentioned, well, maybe I want this as a PDF because it still has these things, these shapes in here that I don't want people to kind of move around and everything. But if I take it now and I just go out of here and go file, I can do this in a number of different ways. You can see I have save as Adobe PDF here. And if I just go save as again, if I go back to the same place where I was and I drop down, rather than doing a Word document, this time I do PDF and I hit save. So now it's turned this into a PDF. So you can see right here is my finished PDF. And this was where I started at. I'll open the image, was right here. So it gives you an idea of the two different documents and kind of, you know, if you could spend more time correcting things. I just wanted to show you kind of the power of that picture correctness inside Microsoft Word. Now, the last thing I just wanted to point out with this, and I'm going to go back to here. And I'm going to just put it in one more time. I'm going to actually delete this here and all the different things that I have in here and grab this one more time and place that picture in that I already did. So I'm just doing some deleting here of the shapes here. Oops, I better make sure that I move off those. Okay, so I want to, now I have this selected, and I'll make this a little larger. If I go back to picture format, I do want to point out you do have corrections over here, and you could drop down and make some quick changes of any of these. So you could go through, if I went and picked this one, you can see it made a change to it. Then you'd have to go through and go back and edit these. So if I go back to my picture format, what it did was it adjusted brightness and contrast, but didn't change any sharpness. So this is why I like to use this format picture to kind of really customize each individual one that I'm doing. So I hope this made sense today of how you could use Microsoft Word to repair different pictures of documents that maybe you just wanted to turn into that PDF at again without having to redo the whole thing. Let me know what you think about this technique down below in the comments. Thanks for watching this time. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.